somebody would have told me, babe. Someday these will be the good old days. All the love you forget, and all these reckless nights you regret. Someday soon your whole life's gonna change. You'll miss the magic of these good old days.
I was thinking about the band, I was thinking about the fans. We were underground, loading merch in that 12 passenger van. In a small club in Minnesota, and the snow outside of First Ave. I just wanted my name in the star. Now look at where we at, still growing up. Still growing up. I would lay in my bed and dream about what I'd become. Couldn't wait to get older. Couldn't wait to be some. Now that I'm here, wishing I was.
Yeah, you could be the greatest, you can be the best. You can be the King Kong banging on your chest.
You could beat the world, you could beat the war. You could talk to God, go banging on his door.
You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock,
yeah.
You can move a mountain, you can break rocks.
You could be a master, don't wait for luck. Dedicate yourself and you can find yourself.
Standing in the Hall of Fame.
Yeah.
And the world. You can run the mile. You can walk straight through hell with a smile.
You could be the hero. You could get the gold. Breaking all the records they thought never could be broke.
Yeah, do it for your people. Do it for your pride. And you're never gonna know if you never even try.
Do it for your country. Do it for your name. Cause there's gonna be a day when you're
standing in the Hall of Fame.
Hi, my name is Julissa Peña, but people call me Julie, and I'm your senior class president. So we did it, guys. Elementary, middle school, and high school, we survived. We've had so many friendships, so many memories, and this is the first day of the rest of our lives. The future is coming, and I know we're prepared. I know we can do it. We've gained so much knowledge here at Zapata High School. We've gained so much confidence and so much amazing memories, as I mentioned before, and we will continue to survive and continue to be successful in the rest of our lives.
Too drunk, half of my high school fell in love with the girl next door in their daddy's Ford. Half of my main street's mini skirts, half of my main street's dressed for church. I could use some rain and a fresh coat of paint. Half of my hometown's still hanging around, still talking about touchdown. They're still wearing red and black. Go Bobcats, while the other half of my hometown, they all got out. Some went north, some went south. Still looking for a feeling, half of us ain't found. So stay lit. Half of our prom queens cut their hair, half of them think that it ain't fair. The quarterback moved away and never came back. Half of my family is happy I left, the other half worries I'll just forget where I came from. Same place where they came from. Half of my hometown's still hanging around, still talking about that one touchdown. They're still wearing red and black. Go Bobcats, while the other half of my hometown, they all got out. Some went north, some went south. Still looking for a feeling. our hometown, settle down, talk about that one touchdown, raise some kids in red and black, go Bobcats, while the other half of my hometown was in the...
Hello, today we'll be interviewing Ms. J. Rivera. So, Ms. Rivera, how do you feel about working here at ZHS?
I think it's incredible. I mean, I didn't expect myself and an alumni who graduated from Zapata to come back and teach, but I really do love it.
So how long has it been since you graduated, and how long have you been here as an educator?
I already forgot that first one, but it's probably about 10 years because mm-hmm. I did miss my reunion, or mm-hmm. am I going to miss it? Not quite sure. But I've been working here for about 2 years.
Okay. So now that you know the class of 2023 is graduating, mm-hmm. how do you feel about that?
Well, I'm barely getting to know the juniors of this year, and mm-hmm. they're really cool, honestly. I really love how the generation has shifted and people are more motivated. I mean, because of COVID, it's a lot less. Yeah. But now they're more motivated to, like, get things changed, and that's what I like.
So do you have any advice for them?
Absolutely not. But what I can say is that if they continue with that motivation, mm-hmm. they can definitely do anything that they want.
Well, great. Thank you so much for your time. See you at the next interview.
Do something with your life.
Do something with your life.
Do something with your life.
Say goodbye to white picket fences. Wow. Say hello to palm trees and Benzes. They say you got a fall, but I have it all.
Yeah.
And we don't want 2 kids and a wife. I don't want a job, I just want a life. Sometimes the underdogs rise and the mighty fall. Hurt you, but he does. I just wanna give you some real advice.
Listen, baby,
never take candy from a stranger. And keep your eyes open for danger, cause this right here is a twisted paradise.
This ain't the same summer song that you used to know. Cause Jack left IM 30 years ago. The world is spinning too fast for you and me. So tell me whatever happened to the American dream. This ain't the same song.
Sleeping down.
hope when you take that jump, you don't feel the fall. Hope when the water rises, you built a wall. Hope when the crowd screams out, you're screaming your name. Hope if everybody runs, you choose to stay. Hope that you fall in love and it hurts so bad. Say
Wow, 28 years. So in those 28 years, sir, was there any surprises?
Yeah, COVID. I think it shocked everybody. Not that there was a flu. Mm-hmm. I mean, we've all experienced that every year. It's the nature that it became, the pandemic that it became, and how it changed all of our lives, but more importantly, this institution. It changed everyone's educational experience, from the student to the staff to the teachers, everybody. It probably will never be the same again since it happened.
Yeah, it probably won't. Do you recall any good things, though, that COVID has impacted?
I like teaching over the internet. That was a blast. I really enjoyed it. I like teaching from home because when I was done, I was already at the house. You know, the kitchen's right there, the bathroom's over there. I liked it. And I think if you were a student and you'd been in school your whole career, that had to be refreshing for a while. The only trouble was it was against a backdrop of fear. We didn't know what we were up against and how deadly or dangerous it would be. But with that being said, come on, wouldn't it be nice to like learn from home on a Friday? I mean, it has a lot of learning, and remote learning has a lot of potential, I think.
So specifically, the class of 2023.
Yeah.
How do you feel about them graduating?
It's sad, but it's a sweet sadness in the sense that you get to learn them as people when they're freshmen, and you really do, it sounds corny, but they really grow as people, and academically, socially, and you're like, just when they start to become these great little adults, mini adults, you know, you send them off into the world on their own, and you just hope they're successful, you know. You get attached to a lot of these kids. They talk to you, they're very nice to you. You help them achieve their goals. You're sharing goals together, and it's kind of sad to say goodbye, but it's a bittersweet, if you will.
I agree with that.
Yeah.
Is there any do you have anything to say to the class of 2023?
Yeah, don't let this setback of COVID, however it may set you back in your life, academically, socially, with your family, whatever, don't let that change your goals moving forward. Be fearless in your approach, and I guess get after it, you know. Get after your life goals, and this was just like a speed bump, if you will, in all of our lives, but we all are moving forward from it. And don't let the COVID years define us. I don't think that doesn't define us.
Right, thank you so much for your time, sir.
Yeah.
If you really want it, got a jetpack with your name on it. Above the clouds in the atmosphere, just say the words and we out of here. Hold my hand if you're feeling scared. We're flying up out of here.
Here we go. Come with me. There's a world out there that we should see. Take my hand. like a G6. Chop the streets of Tokyo, get you fly kicked. Girl, you always on my mind, got my head up in the sky, and I'm never looking down, feeling priceless. Yeah, where we at, only few have known. Want some next level Super Mario. I hope this works out, cardio. Till then, let's fly, Geronimo.
Here we come, come with me. There's a world out there that we should see. Take my hand, close your eyes. When you're right here, I'm all I can feel.
Hello, this is Miss Selena Mata, science teacher here at Zapata High School. That would have to be when you guys were freshmen. Y'all's freshman year was my first year as a science teacher here at Zapata High School. I met you guys at the mere age of 15. Part of that memory also includes COVID, because I got to see you guys all of the fall, you know, but then I didn't see you guys again until you came back to school as juniors. And it was, you know, something that at the same time was very overwhelming, but also part of my favorite memory, because you guys came back as adults.
This
crazy ambience to come back to school. So that has to be my favorite memory with you guys. The pandemic, nothing that was very nice for any of us. My heart is with you guys, because you missed out on a lot of core memories that you could have made on campus. But I think it's made you guys stronger at the same time, because you guys have had to endure something that many never have and never will. So has it affected you guys? Yes. In bad ways, probably, but in good ways, hopefully as well. Because like I said, it wasn't just you guys that went through that, it was all of us. But you guys being in that core area of, you know, teenage adulthood was something that I wish upon nobody. So, you know, props to you guys for still getting through it and showing up your senior year ready to go. That's easy, okay? Life, I don't know if you guys can see that in the back. Life is a journey, not a destination. So enjoy the ride. I graduated from Zapata High School 10 years ago, and I can honestly tell you, I never expected to be back here teaching you guys. Yet, I think something that I took with me, which is what a lot of my coworkers, who were also my teachers themselves, really mentioned to me, was the next few years are gonna be really tough. They're gonna be really, really fun, because you're gonna have all this liberty to do exactly what you wanna do. But they're gonna be really tough, because you're about to go figure out who you're gonna be, what you wanna be, and how you're gonna do it. Now, there is no trying tribulation that you have to put into, well, I have to finish or I have to do this. Go be and do whatever that you want to do. You know, set yourself up on a path that if you see yourself 5 to 10 years from now, you're content with. And it doesn't matter what you decide to go and do, just do something. So that's the best advice I can give you guys. Do something. Something productive, something that you know that for the rest of your life, you would be okay doing.
Yes, my name is Lydia Ramirez, and I'm a senior at Zapata High School. The best thing at Zapata High School is definitely interacting with all my friends and meeting new people.
What are you going to miss about being in high school?
I'm going to miss not coming to class and all my friends that I've made along the years.
And any advice for the new freshmen coming in?
Good luck, and make sure you have your goals straight.
Start.
Hello, my name is Brianna Canales, and today I'm here with Mr. Radigan. We'll be first starting with some of his accomplishments as a teacher, and then we will discuss the class of 2023. So, sir.
Yes.
How has it been being a teacher for 28 years?
It's been rewarding, and it's gone very quickly. What else?
Well,
we need to redo this.
Gotcha.
There is no profound wisdom here.
Are you recording?
No. Oh.
My name is... What?
She didn't even press play and you started talking.
What are you talking about? I pressed play.
Oh,
I did.
In 1944, in Zapata County, two random guys made this high school. And since then, we have decided to keep going. Why? Because we're a county. Welcome to Zapata High School. presented to you by the community club.
You could have stopped running. Yay! So that's an example of what it would be like, except the janitor probably wouldn't be cleaning.
To die.
Okay.
I'm done now.
Dang it. I wanted to catch some of
that. Isn't that funny? Your buddy didn't know you was greedy.
It is. You didn't catch it.
I caught it.
You guys can use that.
It's been a long day without you, my friend, and I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. We've come a long way from where we began. Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again, when I see you again.
Damn. No. All the planes we flew, good things we've been through, then I'll be standing right here talking to you about another path. I know we love to hit the road and laugh, but something told me that it wouldn't last. Had to switch up, look at things different, see the bigger picture. Those were the days, hard work forever pays. Now I see you in a better place. See you in a better place. How can we not talk about family when family's all that we got? Everything I went through, you were standing there by my side.